Hello YouTube, it is me, Turkish Delight, at least according to Disney's next hit live-action adaptation. Cool. Serato is a big topic right now. I have yet to make a video whether or not I think Serato's change is a buff or a nerf or just a change. That will come eventually. We still need to sort out some stuff. We're going to be talking about Serato versus Tenno regardless, so fuck you. There'll be no fights on the screen, so don't worry. Yeah. In case you guys are wondering why I haven't been posting any fight stuff, it is because of the fact that the desync between me and the Americans I normally test and play with is big enough where I cannot actually show anything properly. So I have to record them fighting, which causes issues where you then can't really see stuff properly. So yeah, I'm probably gonna have to ask them to record stuff from their opinion, from their perspectives, and then make a video out of that, which is just a lot of steps and I don't have time to do that right now. Anyway, Serato. What we've realized, effectively, in the, maybe not even this patch, maybe the patch before, but it seems to be this patch, because that's when people started noticing it, is that bleed interactions have changed completely. Completely. It's fundamentally different now. A lot of the old bleed data is now completely redundant. Most of it is perfectly fine. For example, bleed timers, from what we know, are exactly the same. Instead, bleed damage has now changed. And a big one for this links into the Serato versus Tenno, and then later Serato versus Kano. The reason for this is that once you vomit, your food, water, and stamina decrease. In case you guys remember from the bleed test videos about timers, the lower these numbers are, the longer your bleed timer goes on for. We decided to find out how much bleed can we apply to a Tenno with a Serato. So here is the data effectively. In case you guys are wondering, some bonus data. An alt bite to the Tenno's head is dealing 300 damage. Level 3 charge bite is normally doing 235 damage to the body, and it's doing 517.5 damage to the headshot. So yeah, that's a lot of damage. Now onto the bleed. A normal bite by a Serato on the Tenno's head will deal 6.12 bleed. It's not too bad, honestly. All things considered, it's not bad. An alt bite will deal 7.12 bleed. Now, in case you guys remember a video way back, I mentioned this, which is that all alt bites do different amounts of damage, but in terms of bleed, the bleed value doesn't change or scale. Instead, it increases by a factor of about 1%. So I'm not sure if this is a bug or this is intentional. I will bring this up and then I'll let you guys know. But I'm feeling like maybe it's intentional, but it feels like it's a bug. So now a level 3 charge bite to the head deals 13.14 bleed towards a Tenno. Now we have some basic bleed numbers. When you then start factoring in that once you drop below locked health, you take 25% more bleed damage, and your timer increases by I think it's like 13 seconds. But I think the highest recorded case we ever got was about 24 seconds. But I've forgotten exactly what caused that number to accelerate that high. I think that's when they want like the lowest amount of health they could possibly be on. Yeah. So now, 3 bites into a level 3 charge bite on a Tenno's head is dealing 31.5% bleed damage. This is the amount of bleed that comes in before they vomit. So 31%. If you do another 3 bites to the body of the Tenno, because it's pretty hard to get into position to hit its head after you land level 3 charge bite on the Tenno's head, those 3 bites, everything included, will do 50.82 bleed. That's a lot of fucking bleed, by the way. In case you guys don't know, that is a lot of bleed. That is effectively 7 attacks, taking you down to 50%. What we see straight away is that those 3 bites after the vomit did about 20% bleed by themselves, which is insane. But remember, the original bleed value for that is 6%. Aha! The normal 6% bleed, when you factor in that 25% increase and you factor in that timer increase, those 3 bites are now doing way more than 6%. It's small. It's a small change, maybe going from 6% bleed to maybe like 8% bleed, but it adds up. That's the point. The point is that it adds up. Not even 6. 3 sixes is 18. We're effectively creating 2 bleed out of nowhere, effectively. But there's a lot more to this sinister tale. And we start to consider a few other things, which is that if we look at the body hits and the Tenno runs, you're going down to about 32% stam left, and if you're sorry, wrong things. Ignore that part. I'll get onto that part later. The most important part I want to go into is bleed coefficients. I'm making a full video about this pretty soon, because this patch changed bleed coefficients. And in case you guys don't know what this means, this is what I use to refer to the ratio between your standing bleed and any other bleed factor based on movement. So your standing to walking coefficient. For example, for the Tenno. If the Tenno takes a tap pounce, this is about Serato, but I know, just hear me out. It now takes 5% bleed while standing. When it's walking, this will increase to 9.2% bleed. If it's running, it will increase to 10.78% bleed. Because of this, you can basically work out a scaling factor. For example, the coefficient between standing and walking is a coefficient of 1.84. If you round, if you do some rounding, it's 1.84. It's more 1.836. But the game only really goes up to 2 decimal places for most things. So, voila. You go from standing to running, however, it's 2.15%. What this effectively translates to is that if you are running as a Tenno, you are taking twice as much bleed. Okay? Furthermore, if you go from standing to walking, you're taking 80% more bleed. You see, the numbers now start to make a little bit more sense to you guys. I will be posting these in a separate video. I go more in depth about it. If you go back to Serato, though, we dealed 80 point, we got their final bleed down to 80.82 with 3 normal bites, a level 3 charge bite to the head, and then 3 normal bites to the body. This means that if the Tenno runs, it, by all accounts, will actually bleed out with just those 7 attacks. So if you play Serato, like, beautifully, and you get 3 headshots, a level 3 charge bite to the head, and 3 body shots, if that Tenno runs, that Tenno basically cannot run at all. You also have to factor in that the Tenno will be wasting its stamina during the fight, right? Which means that that bleed will also, the bleed timers will increase, so it becomes easier for them to bleed out. What this means is that, given the fact that you can lock a Tenno into place, strategy for Tennos, rather than, strategy versus Tenno, instead of focusing on burst, pure burst damage, could actually be to bleed it out. Serato now has the ability to bleed things out pretty well. You could even forego the first 3 bites into a level 3 charge bite, and instead spam charge bites to get it to vomit quicker. So 2 charge bites, 1 bite, then you just spam body shots, and you keep nipping its body every so often. And you can actually bleed this out much faster. Then there's a lot of potential here. If you do 2 level 3 charge bites to the head, that'll be 26.28 bleed. We're going to say 26 bleed. Then you take the bite. Let's say sometimes you hit the head with the bite. That's another 6% bleed. So you're looking at almost 30% bleed just from that alone, right? Which is insane. If you just do 5 normal bites to the Tenno's head, you're doing 30% bleed. So instead of doing 5 bites, you can do 2 level 3 bites and then a normal bite, and you're doing 30% bleed. That's insane. That is actually insane. So, yeah. It's genuinely really, really strong right now. So Serato could be a very, very good bleeder right now, given the fact that... which is hard to then say whether or not I see the kit as a buff or nerf. It goes very, very well versus Kano. You get to keep the Kano in place, but the Kano can always just run away and deny your vomit. But if the Kano overcommits and you vomit it, you basically level the playing field. Whatever damage the Kano did to you, you'll be able to do back to them during that grace period. And then you're going to be about on even health. And it's just who plays it better at the end. The issue with Tenno, though, is that Tenno is rather quick. So after the Tenno vomits, you can't vomit it again. And the Tenno can start chasing you down. But due to this change, that won't be the case. You can actually now bleed out the Tenno if it overcommits versus you. So it makes the Tenno... it's hard to explain. The beginning of the fight versus the Tenno wants to be very, very aggressive. And then it wants to try to get that tail slam into kick combo on your head to finish you off. But if you play well enough to avoid that, and you know that that is the win condition, if you get tail slammed, you get 2 kicks to your head, the fight is over, pretty much. You cannot recover from that. Unless you play stupidly well. But yeah. So it's very, very interesting. That's about all I can really say for Serato right now. I hope this video was at least somewhat useful, and there'll be way more interesting things that I'll be posting pretty soon. So look out for that. Peace out.